may have standing. To complicate it, the governor of the state and the attorney general of the state of Washington now claim they have standing on behalf of Microsoft, on behalf of the University of Washington. This is an extraordinarily complicated case. I could teach a whole seminar at Harvard Law School about this case.
So let me ask you then, as a layperson then, but wouldn't the whoever is looking at this and reviewing it, would they look at the totality of this executive order and say, you know, maybe they'll look at it and say, this wasn't put together properly. There are too many elements, as you say. Or can they pull some element out and keep part of the legislation?
That's what I think the Ninth Circuit's going to do. They're going to say this is a divisible order. Some parts of it are probably constitutional. Some parts of it are probably not. Mm-hmm. And then, remember, the burden of proof is heavily on the party seeking a stay. Now, the court in Washington said that burden was satisfied. The court in Massachusetts said that burden wasn't satisfied. Mm-hmm. And so we have conflicting opinions and chaos. That's why I think the ultimate decision will be made by the Supreme Court, which is now a 4-4 divided Supreme Court. Yeah. So, you know, this is fascinating and troubling and difficult, but the key is our system of checks and balances is working. The president doesn't get to do what he wants without there being judicial review. That's a great thing.
So, Laura, I don't know if you can answer this, about how long this will take. I asked Alan and the other attorney earlier to explain the process here. We know that the White House is saying that they're going to appeal this. So how long will it take for an appeal? Do you have any idea?
Well, it's hard to say. The White House is saying that they're going to go, you know, as soon as possible to try to get an emergency stay of the order. But the Justice Department is saying tonight not to expect an appeal or a stay tonight or overnight. And so at the earliest, maybe tomorrow, they could go into court and try to get one. But the appeal itself could take a while. And we'll have to see exactly on what grounds the Justice Department tries to challenge this order.
Mm-hmm. Jessica, the president is at Mar-a-Lago, and the question is, does he have his advisors around him? Who is there with him, advising him now? I'm sure that many of them, if not all of them, are watching right now.
Right. Well, you know, Don, this has been a legal and political hot potato all week long. It was 1 week ago that President Donald Trump signed this executive order, and almost immediately protests started throughout the country. We saw the legal wranglings pop up in federal courts all over the country. So tonight, Donald Trump is here at Mar-a-Lago. He arrived at about 5 o'clock tonight. Joining him included his chief strategist, Steve Bannon, as well as a top advisor, senior advisor Jared Kushner, also his chief of staff, Reince Priebus. So we know that they are all here at Mar-a-Lago. You know, this was actually supposed to be somewhat of a low-key weekend, if that's possible, in the first 2 weeks of the presidency. Donald Trump was going to be here at the Winter White House, as they like to call it, over the weekend. He had plans to have meetings and phone calls with his aides and his staffers, but in addition, he was supposed to, and probably will still, attend the International Red Cross Ball. It's a gala that's held every year. This was the 60th anniversary of it. Most years it is held at Mar-a-Lago. It's a tradition that was started back in the 1950s. So yes, we waited a while until we heard from the White House. We got that statement from Press Secretary Sean Spicer tonight, a lengthy statement talking about the DOJ's plans to file that emergency stay, and also reiterating that the White House believes and that they are on firm legal footing with this, that the president has the power to enact this sort of executive order. So that is the line that they have remained with throughout this past week, and it's the line they're sticking to tonight. It'll be interesting to see as this weekend unfolds how this might derail some of the other plans, the other phone calls, the other meetings that the president planned to have. But yes, he does have all of his top advisors with him here at Mar-a-Lago for the entire weekend.
So Renee, let me ask you this question. You know, we talked about the confusion for people who may be traveling, trying to get into the country, and some people are wondering probably if they should leave, if they're going to be able to get back in because they don't know what happened. But should Customs and Border Protection agents, should they be confused right now, or do they have their marching orders to let people in? For clarity.
Well, for clarity, what we're being told is that some guidance has already been put out tonight. And so airlines...
Can you imagine being one of those agents? I mean, what do you do and what don't you do?
Mm-hmm. Right. So the guidance that was put out tonight, I know in speaking to several people within several different airlines, that their position is we're going to follow what we were told at 9 o'clock tonight unless we're told otherwise. So to answer your question, Don, I believe that the guidance that they got at 9 p.m. is going to be the rule until someone says it's not the rule. So that's the way at least the airlines are looking at all of this. So
look, there's a sensible way of resolving this. Just maintain the status quo. Don't throw anybody out. Don't give anybody new visas. Let's keep the thing in status quo. Let's not have anybody do anything dramatic. Everybody take a deep breath and wait for the courts to decide. But I think it would be a big mistake now to start letting people in when they may have to be thrown out, or throwing them out when they may have to come back in. Yeah. Status quo seems to be the right approach.
Easy for you to say, Alan, but I don't think it's going to work out that way, given what we have just witnessed within the last week. We're all on here talking about this ban in a different way, and here we are tonight. Thank you. I appreciate the panel. More on the breaking news right after this break.